Serling. You're listening to The Zero Hour. Rest your eyes. Exercise your imagination. Today, a story by Gussie Bays of love and murder. Remember me? Starring Joe Campanella. In a Mutual Broadcasting System presentation of The Zero Hour.
Brought to you by the Ford Motor Company and Lazy Boy Recliners. This is The Zero Hour on Mutual Radio.
Will face both in the next few minutes. His sweaty hand holds firmly to the blue steel revolver hidden in his pocket as he moves down the dark, deserted street. He stops at a small grocery store, peers in through the window, hesitating, waiting for the right moment. Then a light goes out, and inside an old man moves behind the counter to his cash register. And Harry Norris moves toward the front door.
Oh, you're lucky. I was just closing up for the night.
Yeah, I know. I saw you counting the cash.
From the street? Maybe I should be more careful.
Yeah, maybe you should. Okay, let's have it.
What?
The cash. This is a stick-up.
No, you can't do this. I won't let you.
This says I can. You empty that cash register into the paper bag. All of it. Come on.
But it isn't worth your trouble. This is just a little grocery store.
Get out of my way. I'll do it myself.
No, no. Get out of here.
Get out of my way.
Police, help!
Let go of me.
No, no.
The money. I gotta get out of here.
I'm afraid I'd be too late, Mr. Who are you? Where's Mr. Leibowitz?
He isn't here. He had to leave.
Is Mrs. Leibowitz sick again?
Yeah. She's sick again. I've been watching the store for him. I was just closing.
Oh. Don't I know you?
No, you don't know me. Look, I'm closing. You'll have to come back tomorrow.
Oh, you're Harry Norris, sure.
You know me?
Of course I do. We went to school together. Stuyvesant High School. I'm Ruth Shaw. Remember me?
No.
No, I guess you wouldn't. But I remember you, Harry.
Yeah.
I just need a few things before you close. Here's a list.
Well, look, we're closed. I counted the cash already.
Oh, well, I can write a check. Leave it for Mr. Leibowitz.
Well, okay, give me the list.
Here.
Let's see, bread. Oh, here. Sugar.
Boy, of all people to run into. You, Harry. I haven't seen or heard anything about you since high school.
Yeah. Coffee. Where's the coffee?
Right there above you.
Huh?
The coffee.
Oh.
And potato salad. It's in the refrigerator.
Look, do you have to have all this stuff right now?
Of course I do. What's the matter?
Nothing. I'll get the potato salad.
You haven't changed a bit, Harry. I'd know you anywhere. You know, I never forget a face. Especially yours, Harry Norris.
As I stepped over the old man's dead body to get the potato salad, I realized that now I had to kill her, too. But not here. Someone might have heard the shots and called the cops. I had to get out fast and take her with me. All right, here's the potato salad. Now, what else do you want?
Well, that's all. I added them up as you went along. Comes to $4.75. I'll make out the check and you can start closing.
I'm ready to close now.
What are you doing?
I'll carry your groceries for you.
You don't have to bother, Harry. I only live a few blocks from here, towards the airport.
That's okay. I'm going that way, too. Finish the check.
Oh.
I'll pull the curtains down and put out the lights before someone else comes in.
Well, all right, Harry.
Besides, this will give us a chance to talk about the good old days in school.
Yeah. Yeah, the good old days. There. I'll leave the check on the cash register.
Okay. Hurry, will you?
I'm ready. Want me to get the light?
Yeah.
It's nice of you to walk me home, Harry.
It's nothing. You know, Oh, you have a good memory for faces.
I know.
Sorry, I don't remember you.
You wouldn't. You were a big wheel football player and all that stuff. All the girls had a crush on you, Harry.
They did?
Sure.
Say, who do you live with, Ruthie? Your family?
No, I'm a big girl now, Harry. I live alone.
That's all I wanted to know. She lives alone. I have to get inside the house, get rid of her there. She's the only witness, and she remembers me. I gotta get into that house.
Well, here we are. Thanks for carrying my groceries for me, Harry.
Look, I'll take them in for you.
Oh, no, no, it's okay. I'll just...
Hey, this is a nice place you have here, Ruthie.
Yeah.
Not bad. Hey, you fix it up yourself?
Yeah, kind of noisy, though, being near the airport. But, oh, here, let me take the bag.
Yeah, you fixed this place up okay. Oh, nice view, too.
Yeah. Well, and the plane's taken off from the north runway. It's very noisy, but you get used to it. Hey, come here. I want to show you something.
What?
The picture of you.
Of me?
In a football uniform yet. I still have our class book. Your picture's in it. Sit down.
Yeah, sure.
Funny running into you. I was going through the book a couple of weeks ago, and I was thinking about you, wondering whatever became of you.
You were thinking about me?
Uh-huh. You didn't know it, but I had a big crush on you when we were in school.
No, I didn't know. I thought I was a big wheel in those days. I couldn't see anything.
Yeah, you sure did. Hey, look. Here's a picture of the Thanksgiving dance in the gym, senior year.
Yeah.
You remember?
I'm not sure.
You asked me for a dance that day. Mm. Was I ever surprised? We no more than started, and they stopped the music and took this picture. Then you ran off to find Mona Stark.
Mona.
Yeah, you remember her.
Yeah, I remember Mona.
You were going with her when you quit school, weren't you?
Yeah.
What happened?
We broke up.
Why?
I borrowed a car from a pal so we could drive to Vegas to get married. Only my pal forgot to tell me it was a stolen car.
What happened?
I never saw her again.
Well, enough of the good old days. How do you happen to know Mr. Leibowitz? He's the sweetest old dear. You must know him pretty well to be left in charge of the store.
Well, what's that?
Oh, that's the jet taking off from the north runway. It'll pass right over the house.
How do you put up with that?
Well, you get used to it. Noisy, huh?
It shakes the whole house.
Yeah, you could fire a cannon in here when it goes by and you wouldn't hear it. But the rent's cheap.
You could fire a cannon, and I'm only carrying a .38. Sure, all I have to do is sit and wait. Chat about the good old days, and after the next jet goes over the house, I'll walk out of here safe and sound with nobody to connect me with the old guy dead in the grocery store. And Ruthie, she won't remember anything. She'll be dead. Ruthie only has a few minutes to live, only until the next jet flies over the house. No one will hear the shot. I'll find two bodies a couple of blocks apart, and I'll be miles from here. All I have to do now is wait for the next jet. How long you lived here, Ruthie?
Over a year.
I wouldn't last overnight with that jet flying over the house.
Oh, I'm used to it.
Do they fly over, very often?
They never stop. I'll warn you the next time I hear it coming.
Yeah, you do that, Ruthie.
Harry Norris here in my apartment. Oh!
What?
Well, I just can't get over running into you like this.
Oh, yeah. Yeah, that's the way it goes.
I can still see you the way you were in school. I remember a football game with Astoria High. You got knocked out and they carried you off the field. We were losing the game, but you came back in all bandaged up and put us ahead.
Yeah.
Oh, I was so proud of you. I thought you were wonderful.
Oh, we hardly knew each other.
I knew you. I waited outside the gym that night to see if you were all right. I saw you leave. You had a little bandage right there, where that tiny scar is now.
Oh, this one?
Uh-huh.
You waited around to see if I was okay?
Yeah. I even followed you home that night. I was afraid you might pass out on the street and there would be no one there to take care of you. So I followed you.
No fooling.
Instead of going home, you stopped in at a pool room. I waited outside for hours.
It did?
Then it started to rain, so I went home.
Funny, I don't remember seeing you, and you were around so much. Funny.
Well, I was a pretty horrible-looking kid then.
Maybe. Nothing wrong with you now, Ruthie.
Oh.
I say, you like living alone this way?
Oh, I love it.
Don't you get a little lonesome?
Sometimes. But I have friends in the neighborhood, and we get together and have crazy times.
How come you never got married, Ruth?
Never met the kind of men I'd want to spend the rest of my life with, I guess.
No boyfriends? I mean, no one?
It's kind of your fault, Harry.
My fault?
Uh-huh. When a girl has a crush on a fella and nothing happens, she goes on thinking that maybe someday something will happen. And in the meantime, the other fellas just don't mean much, I guess.
Ruth, I don't get it. Did you feel that way about me?
I did once when we were in school, but I got over it.
Did you?
Sure. I guess.
Well, you're a funny kid. I don't get you.
Oh, forget it, Harry.
I wish I could remember you, what you looked like.
Like I said, I was pretty awful.
What are you looking at?
Your scar. It's no larger than a match head.
Yeah.
I can hardly feel it. And you have another tiny scar on the side of your nose, right there. Where'd you get that one, Harry?
A fight, I think.
Always the tough guy. That's why the girls liked you so much. You treated them so rough.
Did I?
And you ignored them most of the time.
Yeah.
The way you're ignoring me right now.
Emma?
Only inches between us, and you ignore me. Ignore this, if you can, Harry.
Ruthie.
And this.
Ruthie, babe.
Oh, Harry. Forgot to warn you. Another jet just flew over.
Ruthie,
What's the matter, Harry?
I don't know. I must be getting soft in the head. Look, I came up here to do something. Now I can't. And the things you said, the way you act, making me feel like I meant something to you. And all the time, I didn't know you were alive. Ruthie, if I really mean anything to you, you'll help me. I need help. Ruthie, can I trust you?
I'll do anything, Harry. Anything you say.
Ruthie? Are you home?
Who's that?
I don't know.
Honey, it's Jimmy. Ruth?
Is that...
Don't make a sound. Oh. Look, you're going to do as I say or you're going to get hurt. You see this 38? It'll be against your side like this. Act like you've been asleep and answer that guy and get rid of him. Understand?
Oh. Mm-hmm.
Okay, now I'm taking my hand away from your mouth. You be careful. I don't want anybody to know I'm here. You get rid of him.
All right, Harry, I'll get rid of him. What's going on out there?
Ruthie?
Jimmy, is that you?
Yeah. Are you all right?
What do you want? It's late. Of course I'm all right.
Well, why didn't you answer when I knocked?
I've been asleep. What do you want?
Well, nothing, honey. I was worried about you, that's all.
Worried? About me?
Sure. You said you were going to stop by old man Leibowitz's place for groceries on your way home.
I did stop there. What about it?
Well... was everything okay?
Tell him yes.
Yes. Everything was all right.
Mr. Leibowitz was held up tonight. He was shot. Mrs. Leibowitz came down to the store and found him dead behind the counter. Ruth?
I heard you, Jimmy.
The neighborhood is full of cops. They say it happened less than an hour ago. And I was worried about you. And...
get rid of him.
I'm all right, honey. Jimmy, I'll see you tomorrow.
Okay, baby. Don't I get a good night kiss?
No, I'm not dressed. Good night.
Okay. Good night, honey. I'll see you tomorrow.
You killed him.
I killed him.
You're gonna kill me.
I'm gonna kill you. I have to.
Yes, you have to. I could fix you good with the police.
Yeah, you could. That'll teach you to remember old boyfriends. Yeah, you almost got it before, but you mixed me up a little. You made me forget what I came here to do, trying to make me think you cared about me.
Harry, I did.
Yeah? Does everybody in the building stop by for a good night kiss?
Jimmy's only...
I don't care who he is. Why the routine with me? I mean, what were you after?
Harry, why don't you give yourself up? You heard Jimmy. The neighborhood's full of police. You can't get away.
I better tie the spots to this. I always get away. Here it comes, Ruthie.
Harry.
Sorry, baby.
I won't tell anyone, Harry.
Sorry, baby.
Harry, don't kill me.
Sorry, baby.
It's all right, miss. It's all over.
Is he dead, officer?
Yes.
I didn't know whether you'd get here in time.
We finally found the check you left on the cash register. We hit the door just as the jet passed overhead. Close. You really used your head, lady, writing on that check about the killing and telling us where we could find you. Did you see him shoot the old man?
No. I went in to buy groceries, and when Harry opened the refrigerator for some potato salad, I saw Mr. Leibowitz's leg sprawled out on the floor behind the refrigerator. And when Harry came from behind the counter, he left tracks of blood.
I see. How did you keep him here so long without his killing you?
Oh, we had a lot to talk about. See, I knew Harry a long time ago. There were things I remembered about him, but he didn't remember me.
I'm Rod Serling. Close your eyes. Exercise your imagination. And join us again on our next presentation of The Zero Hour.
Remember Me is an original radio drama written by Gus Bays. Joe Campanella was heard as Harry Norris. Featured in the cast were Peggy Walton, Byron Kane, and Jim Bowles. Zero Hour, created by J.M. Kolos, directed by Don Hills, is produced in Hollywood for the Mutual Broadcasting System by Radio Productions Incorporated. Music is composed and conducted by Stanley D. Hoffman, Roselle Sherman, associate producer. This has been a presentation of the Mutual Broadcasting System.